specifics on a price target for Coinbase. You're reticent to maybe give us a number, but can you give me a ballpark on the percent gains that you think you could see, you know, using your 5-year approach?
This is well above our minimum hurdle rate of return of $15, even if it does open, I mean, a 15% per year, even if it does open as high as $250 or $300, even at those prices, given our assumptions. Now, again, we expect tremendous volatility in this. It's going to be unstable in terms of investors and analysts understanding what Coinbase actually is.
Hi, and welcome back to the channel. Today, we are going to be analyzing Coinbase. Ticker symbol is COIN. And it very recently did a direct listing to the NASDAQ. You may have heard about it. Now, I was hesitant to do a video on Coinbase when I initially heard about the IPO, but it was requested by our Discord members to be added to the bi-weekly poll, and it ended up winning. So, me being the resolute person that I am going to give the people what they want. And the reason why I say I was hesitant is because quite frankly, I have no knowledge or interest in Bitcoin or crypto. And my assumption was that the business is fueled by crypto trading, which I've always held as speculation and therefore out of my comfort zone. I do still hold these opinions, but after looking into the business, it definitely opened my eyes as to what a great business and platform they've actually built over at Coinbase. And it definitely deserves some recognition and analyzing as a business rather than just crypto or Bitcoin. And so with all that in mind, I would take my assumptions for this business with a slight pinch of salt, especially how quickly it will grow, because this really does depend on the increased acceptance and trading of Bitcoin, and that matter obviously divides opinion. However, I plan to present all the figures available to me in respect of the industry, the business itself, and its economics, and demonstrate to you what would be required to make Coinbase a good investment from here. So, best start with what Coinbase is. Let's start with their grand vision, and that's to enable economic freedom and create an open financial system for the world. And this plan stems from the original Bitcoin white paper that was created to introduce a decentralized currency to the world that no company or currency could control. The founder and CEO Brian Armstrong was empowered by this idea and envisaged a world where anyone with a smartphone or smart device could send and receive money as easily as they can email, which is why he said he started Coinbase, to promote a decentralized financial system for the world. Essentially, though, Coinbase is a crypto exchange where customers can buy, sell, and store crypto in a solely online platform as easily as they can send a message. So exactly what he had envisaged. And they started with just Bitcoin, but now have scaled to almost 100 different crypto assets today. They have a number of different products that range in sophistication, depending on whether you are a retail trader or institutional trader, but they pride themselves on being a one-stop shop for crypto by offering an exchange, a wallet, and other various tools that allows customers to spend cryptocurrency and merchants to accept it as a means of payment. So really moving cryptocurrency along in the world in terms of its acceptance. And for instance, they introduced a Visa debit card that allows customers to spend cryptocurrency anywhere that accepts Visa and spend money that can then be generated as Bitcoin or into cryptocurrency, I should say. And Coinbase, as of March 2021, is the largest crypto exchange in the United States with over $335 billion in trading volume and over 43 million verified users as of the end of 2020. Now, if you look at how they actually make money, Coinbase makes money through two methods. Firstly, transaction fees. These range in relation to trading volume and if you are a retail investor or institution and what sort of package you have bought into or subscribed to, but it is a percentage of the asset trade value in each transaction. So a percentage of the trade value. This makes up around 90% of Coinbase's annual revenues at the moment. So it is the dominant force of Coinbase's business, as you could probably imagine. But secondly, we have subscription and services revenue, which are earned from offering more sophisticated crypto products to both retail and institutional customers. at a small subscription cost, and also their ancillary products they offer, such as the Visa debit card that we talked about, Coinbase Commerce and Merchant Solutions as well, so more on the merchant side of the business. And this makes up only 10% of the business at the moment, but it's growing just as fast as the transaction volume. So maybe at some point we'll make up more than 10%. And now we need to ask ourselves, how good are the economics of this business? So how viable is it as a business? And looking at the financials of the business, we can see the economics are good. They achieved $1.3 billion in revenue for 2020, which was 139% growth from 2019. So growing very quickly. And it's not just transaction volume. They're not just piling up transaction volume. They are able to monetize this to revenue. They also recorded, though, $527 million of adjusted EBITDA, which is a profit margin of around 41%. I just want to focus on this for a moment. Of course, there was a lot of strong opinions about this IPO and the business itself, but $500 million in cash earnings, albeit adjusted, so it's in their favor. It's taking out some one-off costs that maybe we could argue should be kept in, but that's no joke. A margin of 41% when the company has outright said they're not particularly worried about profits at this time just shows you how good the economics are for this business and how potentially profitable it could be in the future. So in summary for this part, volatility aside, this is a very good product that seems to have all the traits of a cash cow. And for a sense check, Square, which is one of its rivals in this area, produced only $65 million of EBITDA in 2020. Now, lastly, I want to talk about what is the potential for growth for Coinbase. And if we ask ourselves rationally, what is the potential for growth? We have a very large distribution of scenarios, which I don't really like, but I'll go with it anyway. Coinbase's 2021 outlook tells us all we need to know about this and about the degree of certainty around this business. As you can see here, they've estimated a low end for MTU, which is monthly transacting users. So basically the amount of people on their platform, this is what drives their transactions, which therefore drives their revenue at the end of the day. They've got almost half on the low end when compared to the high end. And you never really see this bigger distribution of values or this bigger gap in guidance. And to be honest, the reason why is because it becomes pointless when you see this bigger gap, when it's as materially unknown as this seems, that even the senior management aren't sure and can't give you a real dedicated spot as to what you could expect. Guidance is pretty much null and void in my opinion, and that's the risk we have here with this company. Now, it should be no secret to all of you that Coinbase's growth in recent years and months falls well in line with the growth of the crypto economy's market cap. And although the business isn't necessarily pinned to this number because of the other services revenue business they are building and all of the other things that they do and the fact that it is more of a facilitator, 90% of the business is transaction-based, and it will have a very close relation with the market cap growth of crypto over time because of that fact. And just analysing the crypto market cap, we can see as of the end of 2020, it was around $782 billion, a very long way up from just $130 billion back in 2018. Just for perspective, if we see that kind of growth again, say over the next 2 years, the crypto market cap will be in the region of $4.7 trillion by 2022. That's a massive opportunity for a business like Coinbase, who feeds off the growth of this market and boasts almost 10% market share at the moment in terms of the transaction volume. And for those of you who say it can't reach $4.7 trillion in 2022, ask yourself why not. Not being funny, but it ran up without any fundamental reason to almost $800 billion. So it's not out of scope for it to do it again. And you know, when there is that level of speculation, it's hard to bet against it. But it is also true that if Bitcoin dropped 50% and lost half its value and people no longer wanted to be a part of the crypto market because it hurt so many people, you would have no strong fundamental argument to oppose that either. So again, that's why it is very risky with this one. But like I said, I'm not an expert in crypto and don't plan to be anytime soon. But what I do think is that crypto will be a bigger part of the world in 5 to 10 years than it is now. How big, I don't know. But I think even if people aren't using it as this big decentralized currency in which it was envisaged, I still think people will be speculating, people will probably be trading it, people holding it as a store of value, and that provides Coinbase with a good runway for growth. Not to mention the fact that they are one of the companies innovating in transferring this just store of value over to actually being a means of transacting value. Okay, now the interesting part, my valuation, or maybe the boring part, if you listen to what I'm about to say. Now, I'm not going to spend too much time on this valuation just because I've talked a lot about the uncertainty that's involved in this business. I just want to screen it for you and show you that actually there is some upside here with Coinbase. And look, it is going to carry a lot of volatility. This linear trajectory up 250 all the way down to 25 is very unlikely to happen. You will probably see some dips along the way over the next 5 years. I don't know how big they'll be. I don't know how big the runs back up will be, but I don't think it will be linear. This is just supposed to reflect a five-year average. And this big jump in 2021, 250% revenue growth, isn't just me throwing out a number. They did report Q1 revenue as $1.8 billion just for that first quarter, which was more than they did in the whole year last year. So this 250% is actually conservative. I've kept the profit margins as they are at the moment, even though they've actually posted around $750 million of net income for the first quarter again. So it's likely it will be much larger than this. But this is for the sake of demonstration at the moment. Free cash flow is a bit all over the place. Just because of the cash they're receiving at the moment that's not actually operating cash. So we're just going to assume that free cash flow equals out to earnings. And it's not going to matter much because the main things here are the multiples and the terminal values as always. Now, if we just hone in on that growth there, so we've got 250%, which seems likely, maybe even more than that for 2021. I've got it slowing down quite dramatically in the following 5 years. 50% in 2022 and then dropping all the way down to 25%. Until 2025. You might argue that they can grow a lot quicker than that, and that's more than fair to think that. You could argue that they're not going to grow to $20 billion in revenue by 2025, and you'd have a good argument for that as well. Like I say, this one has a very large distribution of values, but I'm just showing you that if we go with this, up to $20 billion of revenue in 2025, which seems doable, given the potential total addressable market, given the strength of their product, given how profitable they already are, this is a very viable scenario in my opinion. Now for the terminal value, I've just gone with a 25 times earnings multiple. All right, I think it's a fair multiple, especially for a company that's going to be growing at that rate. It would mean the PEG ratio is around one. All right, so good price to get into a stock. We can see in my DCF here that based off of those forecasts, that's telling you that Coinbase is actually undervalued by around 10%, and that a fair price to pay for the stock today would be $91 billion. Or a share price of $348 per share. Now, I want to be really careful here and just say that this is not my exact forecast. I've pretty much admitted to you on here that I don't know how quickly Coinbase can grow because I don't know much about the crypto market. I do know that they have a good platform. I know they have a very good product. And if you believe in the crypto market and that it's going to grow very quickly over the next 5 years and maybe quicker than this growth rate that I've given it, the 75%, over 5 years, and Coinbase looks like a very viable option for you to start playing the crypto space. In my opinion, it'd be a lot safer than actually just buying Bitcoin. If I had the choice of the two, I'd definitely be choosing Coinbase. For me, it looks like a productive asset, a much more productive asset than Bitcoin itself. It's just a case of it being pinned to a very volatile asset. And of course, we've got ARK Invest and Cathie Wood being extremely bullish on this stock at the moment. They actually come out very recently and said this is way above their hurdle rate of 15%, their required rate of 15%, which is actually similar to what we have here on this channel. So I'd really do your research on this one before jumping in. But hopefully this has been either a good educational video as to what Coinbase actually is, if you were hearing all of the hype around it but didn't know much. And then also hopefully a good screen of the stock to show you what sort of growth would be needed out of Coinbase to make a good return off of this chunky market cap that it's been given today at IPO. But that's about it for this video, guys. If you enjoyed the video, leave a like, subscribe to the channel if you haven't already. Comment down below, let me know what you think of Coinbase. This is going to be available on the Patreon page, on the Discord page. This is the reason why it was actually put up on here. The Discord members and the Patreon members get a bi-weekly poll choosing the next stock that I cover on this channel. So go ahead and check that out if you're interested in supporting the channel. You get many other benefits as well. But until next time, good luck with all of your investments. I will see you in the next one.